Sein Gegner ist die aktuelle Nummer 3 der Weltrangliste. Ein zweifacher Sieger der European Darts Open, früherer WM- und Premier League-Finalist und ehemaliger UK Open Champion. Zeit, die Halle auf den Kopf zu stellen mit Snakebite Peter Wright!
More spot in the quarterfinals up for grabs at the European Darts Open. It's either going to go to the unseeded Ross Smith or a man who's won this title twice before and made the final two more times beyond that. It is Peter Snakebite Wright, arguably the most successful player ever at the European Darts Open. Grand MVG has won it three times, but he's not made four finals here. Peter Wright, second only to MVG on the European Tour circuit for the number of titles he's won. He's got six in total. Yes, that's dwarfed by MVG's mighty total of closer to 30. But it's certainly better than anybody else. Phil Taylor and Michael Smith next on the list with four Euro Tour titles apiece. But Wright, unlike Smith and indeed Taylor, still in the hunt for another one this weekend. And he will be the favourite against Ross Smith here. However, Smudger is not to be underestimated. Quarterfinalist at the UK Open recently. He's already taken care of Simon Whitlock and Ricky Williams. And I think he'll fancy having a crack at the number three seed here. Paul Mickelson joins me for the final game of the round of 16 here at the Ostermann Arena in Leverkusen. It is Snakebite and Smudger for a spot in the last eight to face Daryl Gurney.
I fancied Ross Smith to give Whitlock trouble.
He did?
And he did. Gotta give Whitlock some credit though, he put up a very good fight. Ultimately he came up short with a couple of missed darts at double at the end. But right last night against Hybrex was very, very good. Now one thing that Wright has been doing lately is he hasn't really been changing the equipment that much. He's settled with the diamond grip darts, but he's got the different grip now. He's thrown them a little bit more direct with the streamlined flight. He's gone through a couple of different weights of them, but he seems to prefer the lighter version. And I'm not sure whether he's trying to get the darts under each other or over the top of each other or side side. But I think it's a plan in progress.
Yeah, well, he has flitted between them, and I haven't spoken to Peter about it, but on the Pro Tour this year, 100. He's in the top six in the averages list, and he's hitting a lot of 180s. He's hit 60 of them, and he's hitting them regularly as well. Now, for the Premier League, he's been using a heavier dart to try and counteract any drafts or problems in these big arenas, because he feels that they're more stable, and that does mean that it's less likely he's going to hit as many 180s. Even though he's still piling them in the Premier League, it has to be said. I'm not sure what he's decided on here in Leverkusen. Yes, it is a big arena, not to the same extent as we've seen in the Premier League, of course. You know, not 12,000 arena in Berlin, as we have on Thursday night.
Well, judging by the look of the dart, it looks like the later ones.
They look smaller, don't they? And you could fit a few more in there.
It doesn't matter what weight he uses, really. He definitely has got the knack of this new grip on the skinny dart. And 80. He's playing really well. 62. He's, of course, in the other half of the draw to MVG. But he's in the same half as Crossy. Single 20 for the 16 for an opening 12 dart leg.
46.
Well,
127 in game.
It could well be. Might need to be for Ross Smith here. Trouble 19 and ball required. Not to be.
I've already seen one
55.
Fantastic 127 game shot today from Rob Cross, which really did change that game with Johnny Clayton. A double eight is a very solid start from Snakebite, and I'm not even sure if he's aware. Dan Dawson, he didn't make the semis today. He's going down to number four in the world.
No, I'm not sure whether he will be aware. Peter doesn't strike me as a player who is overly obsessive about the tables or anything. He does obsess about titles. He does, you know, has his eyes firmly on the prize. And finals aren't good enough. Runners-up spots aren't good enough. Ross Smith piles in a maximum to start leg two. In fact, the start of 2017, when Peter Wright went on to have the best year of his career, and one of the best years we've seen from anybody in PDC history, picked up double digits in the number of titles won. He started that year, he threw all his runners-up trophies out. As Ross Smith, five perfect darts.
Well, the tail of the tape is this. If Peter Wright makes the semi-finals, but doesn't make the final, he will be on exactly the same money as Harry Anderson, but he will be higher in the rankings because of countback, because he's been playing more recently than Gary has. So it's getting pretty squishy between the places between sort of 2 and 6. And we do want some change up there, because it feels like the Michael van Gerwen statue that is world number one isn't going to change anytime soon.
Yes, Michael van Gerwen could stop playing for a number of months and still number one in the world. Trouble 17, and loves this checkout, Peter Wright, but he cannot produce it here, and Ross Smith can break back immediately. Is Ross Smith a trouble 15 man or a trouble 19 man?
We're about to find out.
Double 5 man is what he's hoping.
80.
Not to be.
Can't afford to have those misses. Just ask Kim Heibrecht after the last game of last evening's session. And Wright was pouncing last night with some excellent doubling. And he's just checking. I think the flight is obscuring that treble. Just wanted to make sure. And that's a good thing to do if you're not sure. The last thing you want to do is go for the wrong thing. But the right thing is double 16.
That is the right thing. A 64 checkout. And that is a leg there where Ross Smith started with 5 perfect darts. And because he missed the one dart he was able to get at the outer ring, Peter Wright just stepped in, cleared it up, and went 2-0 up. They are demoralising for you.
I was going to ask you, Dan, I know you're a fan of 80s stuff, aren't you?
It was all right. It was a confusing and strange 50 time, 50. The 80s.
Well, of course, we've been talking a lot about the 80s. You know, when we come to Germany, it's like being in the 80s most of the time. I always wondered where Peter Wright got his inspiration for the snake bite image. And I thought that it was a band called Zigzag Sputnik. Do you remember those?
No.
They were very famous for a song that was in the soundtrack to Ferris Bueller's Day Off.
All right, okay.
They were noted for their Mohican haircuts.
Right, okay.
I thought he got it from that, but I have never asked him.
That, well, there we go. That's, we've got a little 1980s culture tour for 60. You with Paul Nicholson. I mean, admittedly, look, I was born in late 1982. Like, you know, I was a child.
Well, you'd be young enough to remember things like, well, Keith Houchen's diving header in the 87 FA Cup final against one of the best goals in FA Cup finals. You would have been, what, 5?
This is turning into one of the do you remember the 80s shows with Paul Nicholson, just a talking head.
Well, you've got to remember the 80s for darts.
100.
That was its first golden age with the likes of Bristow and Bob Anderson, who was world champion in 88. Who can forget that year? The year when we found out that pointing at the board was the coolest thing in the world.
133.
Peter Wright's given himself another opportunity to break. If Ross Smith, treble 15 and double 18, that's his route. Oh, it does go. Good stuff from Smudger. Gets on the board. Vital that he doesn't let Peter Wright get away from him.
Yeah, shots like that are proof of how sharp you are right now. And you've got to be against Snakebite.
100.
Mainly playing at the level he was playing at 2 years ago, where he was picking up 5 European Tour titles in a season, but he's still very, very good right now.
134.
Well, the European Tour can do strange things, can't it? Because, you know, we've seen from Joe Cullen, yes, I know. He lost to Mental Sulevich, but he lost with an average at very high.
Yeah,
he's wearing a pair of trousers that look more like a Monet painting. That leaves 96. That almost left double 18. But that is a lovely little gather on that dart. I think that's the kind of dart he's searching for, a la Phil Taylor, when he was using long, skinny darts with a streamlined flight, very similar to what he's using there, just to sneak it over the top.
Well, he is a player, Peter Wright, who does stubbornly stay on the treble 20, and it does mean in those situations he's quite happy to work around what looks like it might be a blocker dart, but often it just seems to be a help to him, and that 13 darter is certainly a big help. 3-1 to Snakebite, and the average is way up there, around about 106. There you say, neat and tidy stuff, that, isn't it? 13-15, 15-13. Beautiful.
That makes good reading. And what's really encouraging for Peter is that first nine. When he's around about that 120 mark, that's where he wants to be, to compete with the Cross and the Van Gerwens, because they are constantly going to be there.
Yeah, absolutely. A strange statistical quirk. You go on there, there's a website called Live Darts Data. It's the PDC's official scoring system. And it'll tell you the averages for each dart. And often it's quite good to know how, you know, the first dart of a player is very often a good guide to how well they're playing. You get the first dart right, everything gets easier. Peter Wright's only averaging 26 with his first dart. He's averaging 40 with the other two. Just goes to show you that Peter Wright, even when his first dart isn't very good, he's able to work around it, to go over the top, underneath, left or right, find a new bed and that.
Yeah, I remember watching the World Cup last year, and there were some alarming statistics for darting splits. I think there was something very similar to that. I forget who it was, but somebody was averaging 24 for the first dart, and something like 47
ridiculous. 93. But he has given himself an opportunity with this scoring to break the Ross Smith throw again. He has beaten him 3 of the 4 times they played. And the bullseye here, is it treble 18? Looking at the ball, but he'll come back looking at 65. Because Ross Smith is doing pretty much what he did against Simon Whitlock and Ricky Williams. He's averaging around about that 93 mark, which is solid, but it's not enough against Peter Wright for the minute.
Yeah, solid is not going to get it done against Peter Wright when he's in this sort of mood. No thinking of treble 11 at all. Might need this. Clinical. Get the chance, take it. Doesn't matter whether it's with dart 2 or 3. And he gets himself that 3 cushion. Another breaker throw, and Smudger has a lot to think about.
A lot to think about, and not much time to turn this around. Now, look, Rob Cross did come from 4-1 down to beat Johnny Clayton, but at the time, Rob Cross was averaging over 100. It was just that Johnny Clayton kept on going out when Rob Cross was waiting to pin a double himself in the early part of the game, and as soon as he missed, Rob Cross was there and just swept past him. 5 legs on the spin. Now, Ross Smith is not in that position at the minute. He's not playing poorly, but he's not playing at the level that Peter Wright is playing. This could well be the biggest average we've seen in the tournament so far. So, 105.74 from Cross this afternoon. It was similar from Christoph Ratajski in yesterday's victory against Michael Smith.
140.
And Michael's not going to be distracted tonight when the Netherlands play against Germany. But he was rather comical with his interview earlier, wasn't he, about how he really wanted to watch the match. And I know that Peter Wright has no thoughts about that match whatsoever. All he wants to do is lift a trophy. And he's doing everything right now. Every time I look at that little number to the right of his score, it's either 9 or 12, and he's well inside that finishing zone. But can Ross Smith do what Rob Cross did earlier by getting 5 treble 18s and double 16? He might not even get a shot at it.
He might not, because it'll be 12. No, he's gambling. And it pays off, because it's double 16. Oh, Peter Wright is just doing what he wants right now. Ross Smith, the 162, means absolutely nothing. Peter Wright nonchalantly ignoring the 12 and ball route.
190.
You get it right, it looks very good.
Are we, I'm looking at the standard of darts throughout the whole afternoon, Dan, and indeed the whole weekend, but particularly now, are we at a point in the season where all of the rust 100. Has been polished off and the guys are in really good nick, but they're still a little bit fresh, they're not tired at all? I think we're at a point now where we're seeing the real contenders coming to the top.
Well, certainly, I mean, look, you'll know far better than I about how darts players feel at this point of the season. But certainly talking to them and interviewing the players, almost universally, the top players, Wright, Cross, Van Gerwen, they are relishing. They're relishing the start of the European Tour. They are relishing being part of the Premier League. They all genuinely think that something really special is on the end of their fingertips, and if they just get the rub of the green, then a title is there. Dave Chisnell is absolutely loving life at the minute. I know he's got beaten heavily by James Wade today,
91.
But he's playing fantastically. Ross Smith is looking at 108.
To deny Peter Wright a 170 shot for the 90. Match. Now, this would be an exclamation mark in bold, italic and underlined.
Darryl Gurney has just won 6-0 against Dimitri Vandenberg to make the quarterfinals. He awaits the winner of this one.
Oh, ho, 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 ho. Shouldn't have moved, Peter. He went to the left and the dart went to the left.
Halves his score. Ross Smith has halved his score with his first dart. So only gets one at double four.
Game Sean, the seven player,
holds
Russell.
His nerve.
Hey, Blake Peter to throw first. Game on.
Yeah, you just never know. He gets that shot there. There's no guarantee that Peter is going to come out of the traps again, but the way he's been playing, do expect it. Ross Smith hanging in there by the skin of his teeth.
100.
Yeah, a ton right now for Peter Wright. It's a bad score because he's just hitting whatever he wants, pretty much.
Must be people who have been defeated on a European tour stage. If you're in good form like Ross Smith is, and let's say he does get beat here, the worst feeling is that you're not going to go there again. It's just horrible because you would do enjoy it so much.
57.
Great atmosphere here in Germany, no matter where we go. Same for the likes of Denmark, Netherlands, Czech Republic this year. She'll be absolutely off the hook. But it's that feeling that,
96.
Oh, I'm not going back up there. It's rather depressing.
Well, you want to make the most of it, don't you? You know, yeah. You're playing well. You know that special things can happen. Give me a chance. Let me at him.
All you ever want is one dart 100. To win the title. And it's not about the money. It's not about the rankings. It's about the opportunity. You've lost the opportunity to win the title.
60.
Well, for a change, Peter Wright isn't down to a finish after the first three visits in a leg. But he's going to be after the first four.
Little squint there, as if to say, all right, where's this one going? Over the top?
100.
Too much juice on it. Crowd, phenomenal order on a Sunday, as usual. More of a family atmosphere on a Sunday afternoon as opposed to the melee that is a Saturday night.
Well, Peter Wright, he took out this finish, I believe, in the first leg against Kim Ibrex last night. Not going to take it out
in what would have been the last leg against Ross Smith here. And there's a chance Smudger could break here and get himself back into this match. The 85 has already gone. Sorry, he had a go at the 85 and missed double five. Now he gets two at double top. Ooh, pulled it down.
75.
Fractions.
Pity require 100.
He might only need two dots for this. Interesting to see where he goes. Well, that's the one he didn't want. And he didn't get a song like that from Olivia Newton-John.
Rotary required 10.
Double five then. Looking to go straight at it. Yeah, very good. Very good, Ross Smith. Now, this game is not over. It was looking like it might be a procession for the stupendous Peter Wright, averaging closer to 110 than 100 for the majority of this game. But that has dipped quite alarmingly with those missed darts.
121.
And a bit of aggression from Ross Smith. He believes he can turn this around.
Yeah, he's grafting all right. He believes. He knows he's only got three more legs. Easier said than done, of course. I was talking to Ross at breakfast this morning, and I walked up to him and said, "How's your neck, Ross?" He said, "What are you talking about?" I said, "That celebration against Whitlock yesterday was a bit animated. You look like you hurt your
59.
Neck." He said, "Actually, it did tweak a little bit." Yeah, but he asked me if there was anything wrong with being that aggressive, and I said, "Au contraire. That's what we want to see. We want to see passion and willingness to win." It was a great performance from Ross yesterday against Whitlock. Hasn't been an easy track for him to get here. He's had Chris Dolby in his way, Conor Whitehead, and Whitlock, as well as Ricky Williams, even though Ricky didn't really turn up. But then again, Ricky did enter, which is what Max Hopp did not.
Yes. Max Hopp will find it very difficult to add to his tally of PDC senior ranking titles if he does not enter the tournament.
100.
Don't worry, we will be seeing Max Hopp on the Euro Tour this year. Might be seeing Ross Smith in the final session of action at the European Darts Open at this rate, because he really is
100
digging deep.
Peter Wright's got to get urgent here. It's almost like he's looking to fall over the line as opposed to running up past it.
Ah, here we go. Running shoes on. And sprinting for the line. Treble 20 first darts. Treble 15 for Ross Smith. Double 18 for a 141. Oh my word.
Well, he's never going to hit it. It's not for a 9 darter. But that was a real scare for Wright. Now he has it in his own hands, something a lot more doable than 170 or 100. To get this done, it'll be 20 in tops. Tops to get it done.
And Peter Wright does get the job done. 180 followed by a 78 checkout. And he manages to fend off Ross Smith, who was threatening to put together another comeback at this European Darts Open final day. But Peter Snape by Wright is on course to make the final of this tournament for an incredible fifth time in his career. Standing in his way in the quarterfinals is the players' champion, Daryl Gurney. And that completes our last eight lineup. We will be back quarter past seven tonight, local time. Michael van Gerwen kicks things off against Gerwin Price. That could be an explosive and fiery encounter. Mensur Suljovic and James Wade will follow in that half of the draw. Justin Pipe, an absolutely heroic effort from him this weekend, takes on the former world champion Rob Cross. And then it will be Gurney versus Snakebite as they all fight out for a spot in the semi-finals. The quarters, the semis and the final to come tonight here on BDC TV, and bookmakers across the world join us in a couple of hours as the European Darts Open, the first Euro Tour event of 2019, comes to its no doubt thrilling conclusion in Leverkusen.
From a congratulations, first of all, through to the quarterfinals. But for the longest part of that game, it looked like I could come out here and congratulate you on the highest average of the tournament so far. And then last, for the longest part, you were like 107 or something. And then last three legs, the average dropped by 6 or 7 points, and you almost let him back in. What happened?
I don't know. Ross obviously started off really slow. I started really fast, but Ross is a fantastic player, and I got away with it, so I'm happy. But thank you, everybody. You know.
Yo. They like your hair. They like your hair. Ich habe ihn gefragt, für die längste Zeit. Für die längste Zeit des Spiels sah es so aus, als ob Peter den höchsten Average des Turniers spielen würde. Stand bei 117 Punkten. Dann gegen Ende ging der Average nach unten und er hat Ross Smith wieder so ein bisschen reingelassen. Er sagt, ja, ich habe sehr gut angefangen, ordentlich gescored, gut gecheckt. Und am Ende kam Ross dann nochmal so ein bisschen auf. Next round, quarterfinals, is Daryl Gurney. You played him at the beginning of the month in the Premier League. It was a 6-6 then. Is it going to be a close affair again here?
Well, it's got to be a winner this time, so hopefully it's me. Well, last time, obviously, I was leading and letting back in. So hopefully I'll just go away and win the match.
Das letzte Mal hat er seinem Gegner, den er jetzt im Viertelfinale hat, Daryl Gurney, Anfang des Monats in der Premier League gegenüber gestanden. Da ist es 6-6 ausgegangen. Sagt er, ja, 6-6 wird es nicht nochmal ausgehen. Einer muss gewinnen diesmal. Ich hoffe, dass ich es sein werde. In der Premier League habe ich ihn wieder ins Spiel kommen lassen. Da war ich vorne. Das soll mir nicht nochmal passieren. Wir wünschen ihm dafür viel Glück. Snakebite, Peter Wright.